Welcome to Columbia Catholic Ministry. Now, here's your weekly update from Father Dan O'Reilly.
Many of you are probably away on spring break, but here in New York City, St. Patrick's Day is one of the biggest celebrations of the year. St. Patrick is the patron saint of the Archdiocese of New York, and so that's why our cathedral is named in his honor. St. Patrick's Day features a parade that goes up Fifth Avenue that's been going on every year since 1762. You see lots of shamrocks and lots of parties and lots of celebrations of Irish music, food, and culture. But who was St. Patrick anyway? Well, he was born at the end of the 4th century. We're not exactly sure where he was from, but we do know that as a young man he was kidnapped and sold into slavery. He worked in Ireland as a slave for quite a few years until he finally managed to escape back to mainland Europe. Once he got there, he studied for the priesthood and returned to Ireland as a missionary, where he brought the faith to what had been a rather pagan nation. St. Patrick was very successful in converting people to the faith. The tradition is that he used the shamrock to teach about the Trinity, that just as there's three leaves in this one plant, so there are three persons in one God. People embraced St. Patrick here in New York as many Irish people came here looking for a job, looking for work, and looking for a better chance at a new life. And the Catholics who gathered here embraced St. Patrick as their patron because he could sort of watch over them and they could pray for his intercession so that they could live proud new lives. All of my grandparents were actually from Ireland. They came here in the early part of the 20th century looking for work. And in fact, one of my grandfathers marched in that famous St. Patrick's Day parade. But he didn't last all that long. He would tell the story that he marched with his county band from Cavan. And he said the band really was more of a party group. Instead of practicing for the parade, they sometimes would just go out and start drinking. So when they went up Fifth Avenue, they didn't always sound so good. So my grandfather played in it one year, and then another year, when he came back, he saw the same problems happening. So the drum major of the group asked if anyone had any suggestions how to improve the Cavan band. And my grandfather raised his hand, and they called on him. They said, yes. He said, I think it might be a good thing if the members of the band learned how to play their instruments. Well, there was dead silence in the room. The drum major asked if anyone had any other suggestions, and my grandfather raised his hand again. And they called on him, and he said, well, I think it might be a good thing if we got a new drum major. Well, that didn't go over very well either. So my grandfather stood up, looked around, and said, never mind. I'll let myself out. And so my grandfather understood that if you wanted to give honor to St. Patrick and glory to God, it needed to be done right. It needed to be done with excellence. St. Patrick himself used his many gifts and talents to bring the faith to Ireland and to fill the people of Ireland with love. We too can use our gifts and talents well to make great offerings to Almighty God. Inspired by greatness, we can do great things for Almighty God.